Well, good evening, everybody. So I just got back to the room. And look what was waiting for me. I think it's a little dog. Or it could be a rat. Dog or a rat, I'm not sure. Either way, I'll just say it's dog. Because dogs are cuter. Anyway, so I just got back from an entertaining filled evening, let's just say. 1887. That's the steampunk type ice show. This one was quite a bit better than the one on Oasis, and I think it's just because like the era that it's set in, you know, 1887-ish time period. I don't know, it just seemed like it was better. There was a lot more technology involved. You could see a lot of projection mapping, which I thought was really cool. Kind of, there was one point where they like flooded the floor and it actually looked like the floor was changing into a pool of water. It was very cool. There was also, you know, of course, some other elements technologically wise that I thought was pretty neat. Anyway, how about I just show you some clips? How about that? Go ahead and take a look. Let me know in the comments what you think. What did you think? Pretty cool, huh? Anyway, so after 1887, I rushed up to the Aqua Theater because that show was starting like 20 minutes after 1887 ended. And people on the ship like to get in lines like 30 minutes before a show starts so they can get good seating. But it was no problem. I got a seat right away as soon as I got there. Pretty good seat. This show, I think it's a new show. It's called The Fine Line. It's very cool. It's very similar to Aqua 80 in a sense that it has the same elements. You know, they've got the guys jumping up and down on the tightrope. They've got people flying throughout the air. There's, what do you call it? A guy on a high wire, you know, about 60 feet above the theater or like 110 feet above the water. Walking across, that was very cool. I mean, it was very hard. You can tell it's very hard to do, not only on plain land, but when you're on a ship and the ship's swaying and it started raining, obviously it makes it a lot more difficult. So I'm very talented. I think he fell off like once or twice, but it was very cool nonetheless. I mean, still, it's gotta be so incredibly hard to do what he was doing. They also had the same type of, you know, high dives, although there were not nearly as many jumps from the tallest platform as there were in Aqua 80. But it was a very cool show nonetheless. A lot of dancing, a lot of playing in the water, which I thought was cool. It kind of reminds you of the show O at the Bellagio with Cirque du Soleil. Just I guess because of all the water elements, but how about I just go ahead and show you some clips from it and you let me know in the comments what you think of the show. Woo! pretty cool, huh? So what did you think? Go ahead and let me know in the comments, again, you know, what you thought of the clips that you saw. Is this a show that you would like to see on board an Oasis-class ship? Again, these are only on Oasis-class ships because they're the only ships on the ocean that have aqua theaters, which is pretty cool. So you've only got five chances or five ships in the world to be able to see a show like this. So yeah, if you like the content, again, please go ahead and hit that like button. It really helps out my channel. Also, if you wouldn't mind subscribing, if you'd like to see more content in the future, I've got several cruises planned already. Well, two anyway. In February, I'll be going back on the Freedom of the Seas, which is where it all began for me many years ago. And then later again in May, I will be going back to Alaska on the Ovation of the Seas, which is an incredible ship. And if you haven't seen my cruise vlog from that trip, you can go ahead and find it here on the channel.
Escalator on a cruise ship. Who'd have thought?
Good morning, everybody. Well, as you can see in the background here, we are in St. Thomas today. Got the Celebrity Constellation Park next to us today. We're parked in Crown Bay, which is not the typical cruise port, I don't think, because this is right by the airport. And I think the other cruise port is on the other side of the bay. But yeah, it's a gorgeous day. I don't have anything planned, like I said prior. I'm just gonna be walking around the town here, checking things out. It is required that you have to wear a mask all throughout St. Thomas. So I guess even whether you're inside or outside, you gotta wear a mask. And we've got little thirsty friends here. Cute little fella. Just wants a sip of water. Oh, there he goes. So yeah, like I said, just gonna walk around the port area here, check it out, see what kind of shops they've got, and we'll go from there. Hopefully it'll continue to be a nice day here in St. Thomas. For breakfast, as you can see, I had the French toast, which was delicious at Johnny Rockets, and the fried potatoes with bacon and cheese and an egg on top. But yeah, Johnny Rockets, if you didn't know, is a complimentary breakfast in the mornings, but you do have to pay for lunch and dinner if you, well, I'm not sure if they're open for dinner, but you do have to pay for lunch if you want to eat there for lunch. So strange to see an American flag in such a beautiful place in the tropics. You would never think to see an American flag in a tropical Caribbean sort of place. So it's a beautiful day here in St. Thomas. Tomorrow we are at sea, as you can see. Sea, lots of the word sea. 82 degrees today, so perfect day today. It's not too hot, not too cold, a little bit windy. 63% humidity, and that's about all she wrote. What's going on, everybody? So today, been a good day. Went and walked around the town a little bit, didn't really find much of anything to buy. I did need to get a little bit more sunscreen, so I did pick up a bottle of that. Let's see. Just finished lunch. As you can see, had some chicken nuggets. The chicken nuggets are pretty good. The Mexican style ribs were fantastic. Very tender, tasty. Macaroni and cheese has always been good, as you've seen from previous videos here. And let's see, the cream corn was quite delicious as well. Ooh, that's really bright. So for the rest of the day, that must be the celebrity ship getting ready to leave. Might go back to the pool for a little while. Got quite a bit of sun this morning. Gotta really put on a lot of sunscreen because the sun is pretty strong. For tonight, I've got Forever is the group that's performing. They're a singing group, I believe, from what I read, and they do songs from like Queen and El Divo, so that'll be pretty interesting. They are having some fun down there. Can't zoom in anymore though. Lit up in red. They've also added some more decorations throughout the day here. You can see they've got some ornaments hanging and such like that. So it's starting to look a lot like Christmas. So you can see here the Rising Tide Bar is rising. Going up to the 8th deck to go end up in Central Park. And they've got a few more decorations here for Christmas. Poinsettias, all that kind of fun stuff. I'm sorry for the lines going across the screen. I'm not really sure what causes that. Here's the menu for this evening. I remember having the beef stroganoff and really liking that, so I'm definitely going to have that for the main entree. Have to get the escargot again, of course. I might try the baked potato soup. That sounds kind of good. Can't go wrong with that, hopefully. Although the soup I had in the Windjammer, I had cream of broccoli, and it was very watery. So if this is like that, I probably won't like it. And I might try the lasagna al forno. Although I don't really like ricotta cheese, so I may not like this one either. But I know I like the beef stroganoff, so we're definitely gonna have to get that. So I'll let you know how it is in just a little bit. Well, good evening, everybody. So I just got back from dinner, and it was very good. Other than what I had before that was really good was not so good this time. And that would be the beef stroganoff. The escargot was fantastic, as per usual. The baked potato soup was very good. It wasn't thin and watery. I did get the lasagna. And it didn't have much of a ricotta flavor, so that was very good. It tasted really good as well, so very cheesy. It just tasted really good. And then the beef stroganoff, it was lacking either salt or flavor, or it just didn't taste like beef stroganoff. Maybe it was missing sour cream or something, I don't know. But it wasn't that good. Of course, no dessert. I don't really eat much dessert. But I have to tell you that these crew members are incredibly accommodating. They've just been so friendly, very fast, efficient. I did ask the gentleman, because there is one dessert that I do like, and that's the chocolate melting cake or the chocolate lava cake. And I said, do you guys have this on any of the nights? Because I don't remember seeing it. And he's like, oh, we already had it. I'm like, oh, okay. All right, no big deal. So he's like, but I tell you, I talked to Chef and I have a make for you tomorrow. I'm like, really? Okay, so it's not on the menu and they're just going to make it for me? We'll see. so that was dinner. Nothing else for right now. In a little while I've got the show Forever, so excited to see that one. There's no more like production shows or anything like that I haven't already seen, so that was Grease. And there's no more headliner acts. So the only other show that I haven't seen in, I guess that they're going to be displaying, is the comedians in the Royal Theater. I did see the comedians in the attic. It's the same ones that are in the Royal Theater, but I guess they do a little bit different of a show. So on the agenda for the rest of the time here, I guess will be like game shows or trivia or stuff like that and hanging out at the pool. Other than, of course, Coco Cay. We've got the beach club at Coco Cay, so excited to try that out. And go back to Coco Cay because it's a phenomenal private island. It beats any private island that there is out there that I haven't even been to. I can already tell you it's the best private island in the Caribbean. Okay, in the world. It's better than Disney. Absolutely, no doubt about it, better than Disney. If those of you have been to Disney and haven't been to Coco Cay, I'm telling you right now it's better. The theming, the activities, the slides, it has everything. I mean, everything. It's the only place in the Caribbean that has floating cabanas as well, just like you would find in Fiji. So, if you have money to splurge, go ahead and get yourself a cabana. There's several different options. There's the floating cabanas that are over the water, and then there's the cabanas that are at the Oasis Lagoon, the big pool. There are cabanas at the land cabanas at the Coco Cay Beach Club. So there's all different variety of cabanas that you can rent. They're all obviously different prices, the ones over the water being the most expensive, which also grant you access to the Coco Beach Club, where you can also have lunch at their restaurant. So a little bit of a bonus for you if you've got that booked. So anyway. When I walked into the room today, I found this little guy. His name is George, and he's the monkey. And he was the one that greeted me this evening, so say hi to George. Alright, that's it guys, I'll talk to you in a bit.
Troll the ancient Yuletide carol, la 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 la. See the blazing Yule before us, la 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 la. Strike the harp and join the chorus, la 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 la. Saber dónde y cuándo la vida nos dirá. Sogno all'orizzonte, manca le parole. Ed io sì, lo so che sei con me, tu mia luna, tu sei qui con me.
I did go and see Grease this afternoon, and I was able to get some clips, so I want you to go ahead and take a look. Tomorrow. You know, I feel bad for those people going on Norwegian because